Welcome back, YouTubers, to my channel of an everyday impact and ordinary life of an Aspie. I'm going to jazz it up a bit and maybe switch it up to have these series on the beauty foundations and some other playlists that I'm hoping to create later on. Even though, this, as you are aware, most of this series or videos that I'm sharing with you all are based on my experiences and encounterships along the way on my journey of what I maybe have been through to share enlightenment and empowerment to others around me, basically, and also to give the heads up that they're not alone. This topic has been really got me thinking, even though it's a real sensitive topic. I feel that some of these topics that are sensitive, be it depression, be it rape, be it suicide, be it whatever, I'm going to address to you all that it needs to be shared more and make it an awareness to why it's all happening, you know. In this day and age, people's attitudes and whatnot is not that great towards all these topics I may be sharing. I might be hated upon, but that's fine by me because everyone's entitled for their opinion or entitled for what they may think, but in the long run, you know, some of their decisions versus their attitudes and that can affect others around them regardless what may be going down. Even though some of these are really serious and we need to maybe address these problems. Like I said in one of my videos over, that I feel that despite us having these conditions or disorders, we should be able to share our story without being judged or criticised or laughed at or just feeling of insecurity that we feel that many people might not listen. You know, this is the problem these days, that some of us, be it female or male, sometimes the male might handle it more better than us females, because us females is all about, you know, the feelings and all that that many guys have told me in the past and present. But in jurisdiction of it all, we need to realise that no matter what it is, that, you know, we should be able to just share it out, you know, and hopefully that if some other person that's going through it might be able to do that waterfall effect of basically being able to share their story and come together. Because I'm all about, you know, hopefully coming together, making awareness, and hopefully make a stand to some of the things that are really important in this day and age of depression, you know, and all these other, you know, situations that comes about in our life circle, you know, dieting problems, anorexia, bulimia, you know, the like. You know, because everybody has their own struggles and issues, and believe it or not, that many people I feel maybe in denial, even though they're trying to act cool, calm, collected, or even just think that, you know, I don't have any problems, it's the other one at fault, or the other one that's the problem. I don't like that kind of attitude, but that's the way the world's going at the moment, that, you know, it's all about me, I don't give a flying fuck about others around me. This is how I look at it right now. Anyway, I, as you know, I am a voice to be heard and listened to. If you don't like what I'm about to say for this, just, you know, deal with it. As I am one of the many women among the Mormon circle, be it young and old, that are being ignored when certain situation arises. So therefore, what I'm going to talk about right now is rape. Okay, so, as we know that sometimes, as many women, young girls, pretty much, teen girls and women, has a big influence on how we act, decide on the factors, or think, or talk, or even just how we dress sometimes in this day and age. Media plays a real big part role for us females, obviously, in general, as well as sometimes now it's getting to be a bigger problem in both genders, male and female, sort of thing. And I feel that sometimes we shouldn't have to, despite the feeling of craving to fit in, we shouldn't have to dress to impress. We shouldn't think, we should be ourselves, really. You know, sometimes it's all right to be popular for a time, but then what about the titles besides the Miss Popular or Mr. Perfect or whatever? Where does it all go? You know, that's the big thing that I tend to question myself every day, you know, where does all these titles go? To me, also, I question myself, is it right that we should be getting the attention that we so deserve and crave for? Be it if, like I said, with the media, like with some of the females that are size 8 to 10s, big bust, big bottoms, and, you know, dressed to impress just to show off our bits. This is downright degrading on us females. We shouldn't be selling our body to the public, you know. This is how it is right now, how I see it in the music industry right now, that how it's addressed, that we should be selling our body to the public, be it males, you know, and like males crave for all that sort of stuff, you know, sexual attention and stuff, but, you know, it's just disgusting, you know, and degrading, and that no matter what, I feel that, you know, we need to take a serious think and look into the matter why it's happening. Is it right that we should get attention or the wrong attention from males that treat us like shit when we have no choice but to bow down to their jurisdiction of what we should be saying, thinking and acting, thinking the same way as them, when in reality we are two different creatures, males and females. Like I said, males may act all macho while us females are hormonal, or whatever the case may be. We females aren't your trophies or even here for the entertainment. You know, we're here to be loved, cherished and supported in that, and we can give you that same retrospect if you give it back to us. Even though I've heard time and time again, what the hell are you on about, Karen? There's no respect back out there right now. It's like, I see that some people may think I'm old-fashioned for the sake of my values and morals, be it respect, self-worth, dignity, you know, self-respect on my own self and whatnot, on how I think and whatnot. Even though, yeah, I will admit, I'm still a bit insecure now and again when I try to speak my piece about what I'm going to go about my day, how I'm going to speak it, and that, well, they laugh and judge me for that, despite that I am different. Even though it's okay to be different, as I'm trying to tell myself 9 times out of 10, regardless of my struggles or whatever I'm facing throughout the day, you know. We're not here to be showing off to your homies, regardless if you want to classify us females as trophies, guys, you know. I'm going to I know and believe that I'm going to be hated on and laughed at for this particular topic, as I'm saying right now about this. But I don't care, because at the moment it needs to be addressed, because at the moment there's not much self-awareness and knowledge and know-how, or maybe just people's mentality, how it is in this day and age of what life should be all about. You know, we should be cool, hip and whatever, but there is, as I said, there comes a time that there will be some situations that will have its consequences and whatever else it may be, you know. I hate it when I hear or see that some girls, young girls and young women, when they dress up, they're a bait ready to be happen for being a rape victim, even though after it happens, it's not our fault sometimes. You know, sometimes many females think it's their fault just because they're dressed up to impress just for the guys, and then, you know, you guys then change the story saying, oh, you know, you can't put it all on us that, you know, we raped you and all that, you asked for it, blah, blah. Do we ask to get raped? No, we pretty much ask ourselves 9 times out of 10 that, you know, if we weren't wanting to dress to impress, we would. But, you know, many people just tend to think, just run away and hide about it. Many young women and females in one of their lifetime will become a rape victim no matter what, however. You think it's okay to be the man you think you are, just to basically be the controlling one or whatever of a relationship, if you were, or just in a relationship, be it a friendship with the female, and then you think that you just want to go high and mighty saying this is what you're doing or else category, which is bloody annoying. To me, you're not a man, you're a monster. You're just downright disrespectful on us, even though you think that us females don't respect you, and you think that we have the high power just to abuse you guys till the cows come home, be it physical, be it screaming and that. You wonder why we get all physical and that on yous as well. You know, we have every right to be safe as well as you guys, regardless that you think that you are safe and secure in your own posse of home, if you live at home with your parents and stuff, or you're just there safe and in your posse just because you think that you choose one person as a victim at a time, you know, regardless, you just pick on the weakest link, and sometimes I don't like that at all. I'm speaking from experience of, you know, what it is. Do you guys really know what respect is? I don't think so, because as I said before, respect has gone out the window. Many people don't know the division what respect is. You know, do you know what honouring someone special means to your life? Because obviously, you never know, when you choose to degrade us females, regardless, or talk behind our backs, thinking, you know, you talk to your homies, oh, look at that chick over there, you know, she's hideous. But be real, you know, be honest here. I'm not the kind of girl that likes to be talked upon. You need to talk to me, you know. Even though, okay, many guys will tend to talk me down. As a young woman myself, I'm humble and have dignity and self-respect to know how I treat myself. And that in a flash moment, though, you know, yes, this can be taken or stripped away if I choose to let it serve them based on my choices that I make, you know, like anybody else. They don't deserve anything from me, regardless male or female. Okay? no matter what though, regardless if I was in a relationship or not, or I don't know what where this is going for this one that I'm with, but it doesn't matter, because at the end of the day, big or small, they need to basically earn my respect, my trust, and my, you know, because all those are important. Because as I've said before, that I've been through so much, and sometimes it's taking a lot of courage for me to come out of my shell and actually share my stories with you all, which, you know, big heads up for me, you know, high praises for myself. Anyway, as a young woman, however, I do believe to be respected like anyone else did. I shouldn't have to ask for this, because like they say, sometimes respect can be gained. And that I feel, you know, I feel that also I have the power, my own very power, to make the decisions, regardless of the decision I make, good or bad, you know, respect what I choose to say. Even if it comes down to, you know, if I'm not in the mood for like a sexual fun, respect that, you know. More of the piece on that one later about, you know, this part that I was sharing with somebody today. If I don't want sex or feel to have sex, I don't have to, as there is a time that I'll be ready to commit myself to someone that does deserve everything about what I have to offer of who and what I am. Because I've noticed that now I'm 10, that many people think that, you know, you shouldn't be saving yourself, you know, you should be out there playing with guys and stuff, you know, go out and have fun. Yeah, it's okay to go out and have fun, but not in the sexual sense, you know. That's where diseases and that come from. Having safe, consensual sex, if I did decide to have sex, pretty much doesn't make me a slut or a whore or otherwise. Okay, or other labels that may you may throw at me. Taking and posing for some naked photos doesn't make me a whore, slut, etc. As I'm hoping to share my views, as I said, about rape, okay? Even though it's supposed to be short and brief. People who share their other photos of themselves or their partners without their consent, you have violated their privacy regardless, pretty much, and their rights. My open clothing that I may wear on to exposing myself to you can lead to an open invitation to rape or sexually violate me. Even if I did dress a certain way, it doesn't mean I'm asking to get raped. When I say no to sex, I mean no, pure and simple. As I said so many times before, I've noticed that sometimes, you know, when I wasn't ready, I just felt I was forced to have it, you know, and I just thought just to shut the guys up, you know, for the hell of it, you know. Part of me feared that I was going to be alone when I was first starting out, you know, dating, and as I said in the very beginning, trying to fit in to all the rest of them, but it's okay to maybe not have sex and wait for the right one. I'm regretting sometimes that, you know, my virginity was taken away early. Anyway, sex without consent is rape, depending on how old we are as people. So guys, you all need to really think. Do you think that you should get away with this and more? Most guys make me sick, angry, and other feelings rolled into one when this happens. You may think we deserve it or ask for everything that we deserve. Wrong. Imagine if we did the same back to you. You know, imagine being in our shoes, so to speak. You know, if, you know, many guys think that they can handle pain and pressure and stuff, but there is a point that us females, we can handle more pain than you freaking guys do. You know, to the girls and young women though, do try and reach out to someone that you trust, maybe, or just reach out and maybe, as I challenge you all, if your girls are watching, raise your voice and actually speak out and share your stories. You never know, there could be someone out there that'll be watching and say, yep, that's one of me too. Maybe one day we can just create a circle, pretty much, and make a difference for us women. We can empower to make a change of what's to come, hopefully, in the future. We need to raise our voice more, however, to actually get these needs met, hopefully. But something needs to be done and changed regardless. We are the ones that can have the power to make the change, and also have the power to make the decision to make be the change, to make a difference, understand. Well, that ends pretty much my topic of the sensible one. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. Pretty much. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.